That's right. I gotta finish burning out this infestation zone.
Beacon St. John to Captain Corey. St. John to Corey, come back.
St. John, I've just spoken with the Colonel. He's assigned you to the Research Division?
Captain, Research Division, I guess you would call it that. I'm helping Lieutenant Weaver and Lieutenant Whitaker.
Good. They can use all the help you can offer.
I don't know how much help I'm gonna be, and just sort of their errand boy for now. And actually, that's why I radioed in. Lieutenant Whitaker gave me a requisition form that says yeast.
Yeast? Hold a second. We have patrols making supply runs throughout the region. When they come across anything of potential value, they note it down. Yes, here. The yeast and other baking supplies were noted in the kitchen area of the Crater Lake Visitor's Center. You know where that is?
Yeah, I could find it.
Good luck, Corporal. Curry out.
Colonel, sir, reporting in. It's, well, oh, Jesus, it wasn't easy. But I got her out. Lieutenant Norwood is out.
Good work, Corporal. I'll send a patrol out now.
She said she could make it on her own, so, I'll radio in later, make sure she made it. St. John out.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Back during the American Revolution, when we were fighting for our freedoms, we gained the beautiful right to keep and bear arms. The right we use to protect ourselves, our families, our property. That is, until the ever-growing federal government got scared of the people they swore to protect. Over the years, they stripped us of every gun right they could, using a few mass shootings as an excuse to curtail the God-given rights of us, American citizens. Gun control. And there went the Second Amendment, ladies and gentlemen. Let me ask you this. When all this shit went down, if every American was packing heat, do you think we'd be in this mess? Hell no. But this is how the feds wanted it. Disarming the public was just the first step toward getting rid of us all. So who did those gun laws really protect? Sure as hell wasn't us, the American taxpayers. Someday, we ever dig out of this, I'm gonna take a poll. I bet those who survived were those who had guns. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Okay, Cope, this time you got me. I'll take all the guns I can get.
Jenny's out of gas. Jenny's always out of gas.
Colonel, sir, just checking in on Lieutenant Norwood.
Corporal, I've just read her report. She claims that you took on an entire drifter camp single-handedly.
Well, I wasn't about to leave her in there alone, sir.
Very good, Corporal. Captain Curry has put your name in for a promotion. I'm beginning to see why.
scrap.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. The feds were whining babies, suckling at the teat of us taxpayers. But dumb as they were, we can't underestimate them. You gotta know the chief muckety mucks are hiding out there in some bunker, waiting for the freaks to die off.
You go.
Say they're hungry, or their precious constituents. You know the real reason they're in power. They save the elite.
An ejector.
The men and women who played
here
ball.
I had all the good shit.
They're sitting underground, probably drinking champagne while they wait. Meanwhile, we're out here dying, suffering. Also the...
An apple a day.
They didn't account for one thing. We're not as stupid as they thought we were. And once they emerge to reclaim the world when the freaks are gone, we'll be waiting. Yes, we will. And they'll be sorry they ever came out of hiding. This is Mark Cooper for Radio Free Oregon.
Shit, that's right. I gotta finish burning out these lies.
Ah, Jesus, even all the way down here, I can't get away from goddamn Radio Free Oregon.
visitor center. That's gotta be it. I just gotta find some yeast. Kitchen, yeah. That's gotta be in the kitchen. Shit. Breakers. Had to be breakers. Couldn't be fucking easy.
useful.
That did it.
Yeast. Use this.
Yes. I hope this is enough.
St. John to Lieutenant Whitaker, reporting in.
Deacon, Corporal St. John, yes.
I got the item on your requisition form for yeast. There wasn't much.
I'm sure that whatever you have is good for.
So, just curious, why do you need...
Sorry, I'm right in the middle of something. I gotta go. I'll talk to you when you bring it in. Whitaker out.
guys.
Bounty. Okay. Okay.
Would you stop doing that? I can't help that right now.
Well, I live in a barracks with a dozen militia assholes. Well, my wife lives in a private tent up on an officer's ridge. Nothing strange about that.
Deacon.
And the only time that I see her is when I'm done running one of her errands. Nothing strange about that either, ma'am.
My yeast, thank you.
Are you baking something? I mean, if you need an oven, I know where to find one.
No, I'm using it to create viral proteins that they trigger these antibodies. But of course, you are being sarcastic.
Bread, viral proteins, it's all the same to me.
Hey, wait a second. Here. Thank you.
You already said that.
I meant for stay.
No, set them over there. Thank you. Corporal St. John, this is Dr. Jimenez. St. John?
Hey, Doc, this is Deacon. What can I do for you?
St. John, good. I need you to stop by the infirmary.
Is something wrong? You need something?
No, nothing like that. I want to check on that arm.
My arm's fine, Doc.
A burn like that? From a wood stove? It's nothing to play around with. You want la infección? You come see me. That's an order.
All right, Doc. All right, fine. Whatever you say. St. John out.
They're not gonna feed you if you don't work. Please, no. No! No more!
Hey, Doc.
Come in. Siéntese. Have a seat. Have a seat.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Let's look here. So, who did you ride with back in the day?
I don't know what you're getting at.
No me mientas. Look, Corporal. I spent 20 years in East LA patching up bandas de motoristas and every other kind of pandillero. I know the look. And this? No kind of wood stove did this. All right. Keep it clean. It'll heal on its own. Leave a nasty scar. But I want you to come back and see me in a couple of days.
You got it.
Funny thing. When the city burned and the hordes came in, neighborhoods at war for decades all came together. Fought together. Latinos, güeros, chinos, bloods, crips. Didn't matter. Crazy what it takes to bring people together sometimes, no?
Thanks, Doc.
St. John, come in. Taylor, take in St. John.
Taylor, I haven't heard from you in a while. I was afraid that maybe you got in too close to that man you were tracking.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm close, all right. I'm right in their friggin' backyard. Hey, I need your help, man. I'm at a small camp south of Crater Lake, just off the South Rim Drive.
Taylor, listen to me. I have no idea what you're doing, but you got...
Oh, shit! No! Let me go!
Taylor?
Corporal. Hey, you. I haven't seen you around here before. Name's Jacob D'Angelo. Everybody calls me D.
St. John, Deacon. So, you're the guy to come to for hardware?
You got it, pal. You need guns? I got guns. If I don't have it, it was never made, you know what I mean?
Great. I'll keep that in mind. St. John to Lieutenant Whitaker. Come back.
Switching to a private channel. Hold on. Deacon, are you there?
Yeah. So I looked at that requisition form. It says that you want silicate?
Yeah, silicate. I use it as a distilling medium in the column chromatographer.
What?
Sorry, it's the one part of my research that's actually going well.
So, silicate, where do I get it?
Oh, shit, I thought I marked it on the rec. Hold on. Okay, there's this little general store southwest of us near Mazama Village. You should be able to find it there.
Okay, got it.
Thank you. Sorry, never mind. Carry on, Corporal.
Yes, ma'am. Lieutenant.
Sarah, out.
Silicate. What the fuck is silicate anyway?
Okay. So, man, I gotta tell you something.
Okay.
I knew you from before. Well, not personally, you know, but I'm from Farewell. Same as you. And me and my friends, we used to watch you guys around town. The mongrels, I mean. Corporal, see ya.
St. John, this is Captain Curry. Come in.
Yeah, Captain. I'm here.
Well, I just wanted to let you know that the Colonel gives an informal talk every day at dusk at the staging area where you were sworn in.
Yes, sir.
Now, while these talks are informal, enlisted men and women are expected to attend.
Copy that, sir.
Curry out.
Great. Commander who likes to give fireside chats. Can't wait.
Corporal.
Come on in. Take a look around.
Leave, they're gonna make me give back this really cool hat, so I'm starting to like this hat. I mean, really.
Okay, all right, I gotta get back to work. This yeast has already filled up like half a dozen petri dishes.
Okay, save me some of the viral proteins. I got an appetite out here.
I'll do that. Lieutenant Whitaker out.
This looks like the spot. Let's go find some silicate. All right, fellas, how you getting inside? It's all watered up. Gotta find a way in. Maybe up here. I should be able to climb up here. Yeah, a mom and pop store. I want to help.
Who's that?
Silicate. Yeah, well, it's gotta be somewhere. Here we go. Silicate. Somebody didn't know how to park.
Come on, you bitch. Yes. Yes. I just park this anywhere.
Sarah, are you there? I've got the silicate you requested.
Corporal St. John, yes, I'm here. I'm in a meeting with Lieutenant Weaver.
Corporal St.
I don't know.
Weaver. Corporal, report in to me when you get back to the island. Lieutenant Whitaker out.
Fucking Weaver now. What the fuck is he doing? Hey, Doc. You there? This is Corporal St. John. Doc Jimenez. Come back.
St. John, how's the arm?
Good. Good. That ointment, or whatever it is that you gave me, it's, yeah, it's working great.
I'll be the judge of that.
Hey, so I'm actually just checking in to see, to see how well you know Lieutenant Weaver.
Lieutenant Weaver? I know him. As well as I know any of the officers. Why?
I don't know. I'm just, I'm doing some runs for them, for him and Lieutenant Whitaker, and it seems like he's, I don't know, he's in her face all the time, and, I don't fucking like it.
Lieutenant Whitaker can take care of herself. Listen to me, St. John. The Colonel tolerates a certain amount of razzing amongst the officers. If I were you, I'd stay out of it.
All right, Doc.
And don't worry about Lieutenant Weaver. He's no saint, but I've met worse. Jimenez out.
Weaver, I swear to God.
What, are you afraid of a little competition?
God, get out!
Hey, is there a problem? Ma'am. Just a friendly discussion, Corporal. Lieutenant.
What's that all about?
Nothing, it's just... Weaver, he thinks that the answer to everything is just to burn it all to the ground. God, fuck him.
Yeah, fuck him. Here.
Thank you.
No, don't.
What now, Deacon?
Thank me. Don't thank me. Every time you thank me, I end up outside with another one of your bullshit requisition forms.
My bullshit? That's what you think this is? Everything I'm doing is just bullshit?
No!
Of course you didn't mean it. You know, I don't understand why you're still here.
Well, then let me enlighten you. I spent the last 2 years killing freaks. One by one, up close. So close that I could smell the flesh rotting between their teeth. So if you're working on something here that's gonna take them all out at once, fuck it, I'm in. But if you don't want me here, you know what? Just give the order, ma'am.
Deacon, wait. I'm sorry, okay? Look, I do need... I just... I appreciate your help.